Well, of course, I'd love to see you, but I can't do anything this week. I'm on a mission for the BBC. I've got to find a picture for £500 for the BBC's art collection. Well, of course I bought something for as little as £500. Well, you might not know where to buy a picture for £500, but I have a few ideas. I'm going to start at the Wallace collection. I know that one can't buy anything there, but it has to be one of the most inspiring places in London.
But the painting I really wanted to show you is this one, The Swing, by Fragonard. The scene is set in a beautiful garden on a summer's day with sunlight flooding into the composition from the left, curiously, cold sunlight, in fact, which is captured by the spray of the fountain on the left-hand side in the background, which is delineated by Fragonard.
Come, this is all beside the point. It's the story behind this picture that makes it really interesting. This was a commissioned work. The painter was told to represent his client lying on a bed of roses, admiring the view up the skirts of his mistress on a swing. The real sting is that the person pushing the swing, and hence the instigator of such debauchery, was a leading bishop. Can you imagine a more delicious image of erotic fantasy and intrigue? Such scenes would not have shocked the painters of the time. Their lives were a catalogue of dangerous liaisons, suicides, and misadventures. Even Fragonard, who led a comparatively tame existence, was ruined by the revolution and ended his days in penury and obscurity. That's why I like this period in art. On the surface, it's all sweetness and light, but if one delves a little deeper, there's enough scandal and drama to make the perfect soap opera.
This portrait of Madame de Pompadour was painted by Boucher in 1759. She was 38. It's a curiously subdued painting for a portrait of the Pompadour.
Curiously subdued? This has got to be one of the most uncharacteristic poses the woman ever struck. Let's not forget that this so-called subdued creature shocked the whole of France by becoming the first ever bourgeois mistress of a king. Not bad going when one considers that you had to be a grand duchess in that court before one was even allowed to sit down in the presence of the noble monarch.
Of course, she was terrified at losing the king, at losing her own physical attraction for him. And it's said, in fact, that in order to arouse enough passion in herself when the king came to her bed, she lived on a diet of truffles, vanilla, and celery. This, in fact, almost killed her and had to be given up.
Well, I could have told her that. Now, this is the kind of woman I really admire. One who decided at an early age what she wanted and used her beauty and strength of character to get it. All the pictures I've ever liked have been of strong, dominant women like Marie Antoinette or La Pompadour. It's also typical that the things I covered are the most expensive. When this picture was bought in the 1870s, it cost £10,000. And that was when Boucher was unfashionable. Now, it would be worth millions. That's enough fantasizing for today, and it hasn't brought me any nearer to finding a picture. Still, if I can't have the original, maybe I can find a copy or a print from my friend Norman Blackburn in Ledbury Road.
Look at that!
I saw this at the Wallace collection the other day. That's a Fregona.
Yes, you would have done.
Well, this is perfect. This is exactly what I want.
It's sold already.
It can't be sold. You couldn't have sold it. You sure I can't have it?
I'm afraid not. Don't worry. Don't worry. Lots of other things to show.
All right, shall
I? Can I come downstairs and have a look?
Absolutely. Oh, I love it down here. The magic basement.
It's not bad, is it, really?
Lovely. Now, is this where you've... Oh, yes, 18th century French line
engraving. Well, a few French line engravings to show you. Mm. That's a splendid example. I mean, the artist there has this super design. Mm. But you can see the texture there of 18th century French engravings. It's black and white. Gives you a very good kind of feel when you look at it.
Yes, it does. Now, how many of those would they have made?
Well, they would have rolled off of the plate, really, something in the high hundreds, going into the thousands.
Really?
One assumes that a few of these would have been done, but in reality they were extremely popular things at the time. Mm. So they would have rolled off very many of them.
I do not like him.
You don't like him?
Oh, he's horrible.
Very interesting.
What a ghastly face. I mean, would you want to look at him hanging on your wall?
Well, I think the man's appearance, obviously, doesn't appeal to everybody, but the engraver's technique, true. I mean, you must admire that.
Yes,
the
it is.
The splendid
You're
design here
right.
from the artist of having the ships there.
Oh, yes.
The drapes,
see, I didn't
very
see those.
Florid.
How much would this be?
Well, we're talking just over £200, £250 for that engraving. Mm. I think for the quality there, it's low value, really.
Well, I agree with you, it is. But by the same token, if I'm going to buy something, I want it to be something that I would really like.
That you would like, yes.
I would not like that.
I think that's
I wouldn't
good,
put it.
Good
if somebody
comment.
Gave it to me as a gift, I would
No, I think that's absolutely a good comment. If one ever is a collector of engravings, one should always buy what you like.
You know, I only like women on my wall. I don't
I can understand that. Individually, they're well within your budget. But
How much are these, for example?
These again are between £200 and £300.
Mm, I actually need to really get something for about £500 without you artificially inflating the price.
No. Well, you could go for a pair, which would get you to a nice level.
Yes. One of the things I meant to ask you, how do you know, because I know you're terribly honest, but how do you know that there aren't, when something is not a real, when it's a fake? Are there a lot of fakes around these?
Yes, I mean, that really is the nightmare for a collector, both at the beginning and also when he's a little bit into it or her, after they've spent some time at it. But that's part of the fun of it. Mm. You have to make a few mistakes before you get to really know.
Mm-hmm.
If you're lucky enough to go into it and not make a mistake, okay, but the action of making a mistake, making a wrong purchase, it hits the wallet, certainly.
Of course.
And at the same time, you learn an awful lot by it.
Mm.
Let's go on to something else.
All right. Here we are.
This is a folder of light things. Isn't that a
hoot? Adorable.
Isn't that a hoot?
That is so incredible.
It's a super shot, isn't it?
Well,
really?
Tell me about it. What is that?
Well, these are early 19th century, not 18th century. You can see the difference in style.
Mm.
These 19th century things are made from a lithographic stone,
mm-hmm.
whereas the others are engraved from a copper plate. Mm. So you don't get this super 18th century copper plate technique that I feel gives you a great look when you stand back and observe.
But this is brilliantly done. It's almost like a photograph.
They're splendid, aren't they?
Mm. How much is this?
Here's the interesting
children.
Thing.
Les Enfants.
If we turn it over and look at the back, it's priced at £28.
Mm.
Now, the difference between the other folder at £200 to £300 and these things at £20 to £30.
This would be a great present to give to somebody who was a baby, a child, to be in the nursery.
It's a super thing to grow up with. I mean, they'd really enjoy that.
I think so. Well, let's leave that up because I might get that anyway, but not for the particular. But
look at the super nose.
Oh, and well, she is heaven. Look at her face. She's probably only about 35.
Yes.
They aged fast in those days. I think they're absolutely divine. I mean, I would far rather, if I had a very limited amount of money to spend, and put on my walls, I would far rather have something like this than some sort of hideous reproduction of a Picasso or a Hockney, which people pay a fortune for.
I mean, this is
original, it's different. The faces are absolutely divine. Are these all done by the same person?
Yes, same artist.
Well, Norman, I must say that you've shown me some fascinating things, and I like a lot of them, but I really think that I want a drawing.
You want to go for a drawing?
Mm.
Well, you will get a one-off in that case, whereas with prints there are many copies of them.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want that individual piece, then...
I was thinking that I might go to Paris.
Oh, well, bon voyage to Paris.
The Rue Faubourg Saint-Honoré is to Paris what Bond Street is to London or Fifth Avenue to New York. The irony is that you will find most of the same shops selling the same goods in each country. I saw this outfit in Los Angeles last week, and it cost more than £500. But the Faubourg is not just a fashion designer's haven. It's also the place to go for fine art. Didier Aron is one of the most respected French 18th century dealers. His shop covers three floors and is as sumptuous as any museum. The difference is that you can walk out of here with any one of these objects. You may be the odd million poorer, but at least no one else will have the same thing. Art can be copied or reproduced, but there is only one original, one master cast, one artist's print. It's one of the few things that cannot be mass marketed, and I suppose that this is its fatal attraction.
Oh,
we've got even more beautiful things
in
the last time I was here.
Oh, we try. It's not very easy. We work a lot to buy, and sometimes we sell.
They really are fantastic. It is just like being in an Aladdin's cave, actually. What is this?
That's what we call a Terre de Lorraine.
Very pretty.
But it's a lovely, very lovely piece.
Yes, very 18th century.
18th century.
Of course.
That's a drawing, a watercolour by Robert Robert, representing some ruins in Rome.
And what are they doing? There's a woman there with some children?
The women are bathing with some children around. We say, I don't know what you say in English, in French we say les lavoirs.
Oh, that's right,
there.
They had to always wash in the street.
Suite minière, excuse bathrooms. Me.
The painting is beautiful. I love this blue, the blue of the lion and in the sky too. Is it signed?
It is not signed, but...
It's not signed?
Yet it is signed, my God.
You didn't
it's signed there.
Very small signature. How much is this one, Didier?
The price of this one, let me see. The price of this one is £35,000.
Ah, £35,000. Really £35,000, I mean. What is that in dollars? Is it less?
You're a friend of the gallery. I'll make you a special discount.
Well, how about £500? I suppose that's out of the question.
There you can run.
Right, well, can I see something else? What about something by Boucher? Do you have anything by Boucher?
I don't know if we have Boucher now. I asked Didier.
It is lovely, but it's not... You know, I like to see something with maybe a very strong, dominant, powerful woman, because, I mean, I'm... I'm rather mad about Marie Antoinette. You have a little Boucher?
Didier Leblanc.
Just a little Boucher.
Thank you, Didier.
Oh, God, that's so wonderful. Look at that peachy pink apricot. That is divine. That is really divine. And this is a Boucher?
This is a Boucher. It is reproduced in the... You see there?
Is this an old catalogue?
It's an old catalogue of the 18th century. It's reproduced and signed. And it's a very good piece too, but Boucher is a at the price of this one. I'm not sure. Let me think. How much it is? It's £40,000.
£40,000. So it's even more than the other one.
Yeah.
Well, the thing that's so wonderful about having a beautiful drawing by an old master, even if it's only small, is that it's something that you can have on your wall and that you can appreciate all the time. It's not like having money in the stock market, which is also where it's going to go up, it's going to, having jewelry, which is going to be stolen or something. Or I think that it's the best, even furniture, much as I love beautiful 18th century furniture, there's still a certain amount of wear and tear. So you have something on the wall, it's something that you can look at every day, and also you know, it's going up. It was £15,000.
Yeah, but I mean, if you want to buy art, if you want to buy a good collection of art, you must buy it with your own art.
With your own heart, yes. And exactly, your own instincts. You know, it's always been my philosophy, and you tell me if I'm right or not, that it's better to buy a first-class drawing than a second-rate oil. You think that's right?
I think you're completely right. You find very, very few very good paintings anymore. So a good drawing is better, as you said, than a second-class painting.
Well, both of the drawings that you've shown me are absolutely beautiful. I don't suppose you could let me have either of them for £500.
I tell you, Jane, it's so all right because you're a friend, but some people tell me that sometimes, and most of the time I show them the door.
Well, that wasn't one of my most successful ventures, but I've got one other idea. The flea market in the north of Paris is one of my favorite haunts. In some ways, it's a triumph of hope over experience to think that one will find anything of interest here. One is more likely to pay way over the odds for something that's not very good than discover some great, unrecognized masterpiece. But no one can deny the excitement of rummaging through the bric-a-brac, and there's always the hope that today's junk might become tomorrow's most desired item. Look at this stuff. I must admit that I used to like Art Deco. Now it's rather démodé. I think that's why Elton John sold off his collection recently. Chance. Maurice Dreux has often come up with some interesting things for me. Maybe he has something good today.
Maurice,
oh,
how are you?
And you? I am very pleased to see you.
Well, I'm very pleased to see you, but I have a big, big problem, and you
what
have to.
What problem have you?
Well, you're going to think this is very strange, but I've been asked by the BBC to find an 18th century drawing.
Yes.
£500.
For £500?
For £500.
£500. Ah,
yes.
Okay.
Do you think you have anything?
Yes, I have.
You saved my life.
Yes.
You're the last person I've come to because I've been with a parachute.
I shall show you some of them.
All right.
I have this one, if you like. This one is a drawing by... it is difficult. This one is a very beautiful drawing by Delacroix. It is a pupil of David. Would you like to see it?
Yes, thank you. I bought a David picture here, didn't I?
Pupil of David. I think it is a very good design.
But he's got a rather evil face. I think he looks like somebody
little.
I know, actually. Yes. Are these old jugs, these 18th century?
The jugs are, I think, of 18th century.
Well, this is rather nice.
Yes,
I like that. That's very nice.
Very
the
beautiful.
Nicest thing I've seen so far. I mean, of that price. Do you remember that one? That was the one that I almost bought.
That one is beautiful, but it is Italian 18th century.
£500.
Not at all.
It is not even for the BBC.
15,000 francs. It is by Giulio Romano, Italian 18th century. Very sculptural, a little baroque.
What
beautiful.
Is 15,000 francs? I can never. 15,000 is £1,500. It's too much.
But it is
what
very
about,
beautiful.
I have
another.
You have another?
This one is a Flemish 18th century. It is expensive, 60,000 francs, but it is very, very beautiful.
The colouring is so beautiful.
Very beautiful.
Well, I like this very much. Can I see something else?
Yes, I have another one. It is the School of Natoire. It is very typical of art French 18th century. It is with ink, row of wise. It is very, very beautiful.
Almost Japanese-y in this kind of the way they've drawn it. And the women look so sweet, so friendly. And this is what? This is a drawing?
This is a drawing, yes. This is
really?
An original drawing.
An
really,
18th
really.
Drawing.
18th century.
They've got
about
very
natoire.
Pretty faces. I think this is lovely.
Yes, it is a tupil of natoire.
Oh, look, there's a little, what is that, a lamb?
It is a lamb, yes.
Oh, how sweet.
Very
beautiful. I knew you'd come up with the goods. I really love it.
It's very, very charming.
I'd like to keep it myself.
If you like.
Thank you. Well, I think, anything?
May I show you this one? It is very, very different. It is French 17th century. It is a
17th.
Little 17th century, the end of 17th century. It is a little baroque.
Mm.
It is a mythological scene, Médée smashing his children. But
Medea smashing her children to death?
Médée.
I don't think I approve.
It is very terrible.
Yes, it is very terrible.
Very terrible, but it is very well designed.
Well, I can see that it's a beautiful drawing. Yes. I mean, it's a bit fat.
And it is a drawing made in squirrel to be used for a painting after. It is a studio also.
I mean, it's very interesting.
It is a little pathetic, a little bit in the face.
I hate the subject matter. I wouldn't want to.
It is not very...
Very kinky person.
It is not like the other one.
I think I'll take this. So
I think you make a very good choice.
I think so.
Yes.
So how much is it?
How much is it?
Yes.
The price, normal price, is 6,000 francs.
Well, 6,000 francs is more than £500.
Yes, but it is a very good design. But for you, what price I can make? I can make for you 5,300. Is it like?
Yes,
is it good like
that,
this?
That is very good like this. That is exactly £500, according to my brilliant calculations.
Okay.
In cash.
So it is for you.
French francs. Well, it's wonderful. Wouldn't it be interesting to see what an expert would make of my School of Natoire drawing? I think I'll take it to Sotheby's, where anyone can have anything valued.
Excuse me, what have you bought?
Well, I've got a picture that I bought in Paris. What's that?
Well, the wife reckons it's worth a few bob, so I thought I'd check it out.
I think the wife's quite optimistic. I would say that's worth about 6p, if you're lucky.
Help you?
Yes. I bought this picture in Paris.
Right.
And I'd like you to tell me what you think it's worth.
Right. It's a drawing. Julian, I wonder if you'd like to have a look at it.
Yes, certainly. Good afternoon.
Hello.
Yes, that's a very typical drawing with these facial types by an artist called Charles Natoire, who worked in Paris, went to Rome. He was born, I think, in 1700. And died in 1770. He's rather fashionable now because in 77, I think it was, there was an exhibition in Nantes in his honour. And ever since then, he's been going up in value rather a lot.
Really?
And it's very typical because he always does these very, very beautiful ladies.
Yes.
And he's the most lovely painter. And he also painted the cupola in one of the cupolas in San Luigi dei Francesi, the French church in Rome where those two very famous Caravaggios are that everybody goes to see. He also taught, I think, Hubert Robert and...
He taught Hubert Robert and Fragonard.
That's
not true. How do
so
you know
he's,
this?
And he's typical. Well, I'll show you. Have you got those books on the French 18th century?
So this is quite.
He's very distinctive. Oh yes. I think it is. We'll look it up. But look, I'll show you. Let me try and convince you of the attribution, because here these are rather good Italian books that used to be sold. Sadly, no longer produced, but they were sold for £2 on the newspaper stores. They have wonderful reproductions, and look, here's a Natoire here. More finished than yours, but you see these You see this facial type here?
Oh, yes.
This
is very, this yes, is and also the way that these kind of the squiggly wash, bits yes. are going on up there.
I mean, in fact, this sort of shows Fragonard looking. This is rather Fragonard parts mm-hmm. of this. One can see it. And then I think in this book, which is on 18th century Italian drawings, we've got here also, you see, they're typical faces.
Is that Fragonard? Yes.
Look, they're all their sisters, aren't they? Absolutely.
Yes,
sisters.
They must have been his model or his yes. wife or his girlfriend. Or
yes. Well, he was probably also very good looking himself, because normally artists tend to paint themselves in their pictures.
Really? I never knew that.
So when you've got a very, I'm sure Natoire must have been very good looking, because I think all his faces.
How interesting, but I mean, you were absolutely positive that's a Natoire.
Absolutely, no
even
doubt.
Without the signature or anything.
No signature.
I mean, it's not,
needed,
and
yes.
you can see that it's a drawing. It's a very good drawing, yeah. or is it a part of a drawing?
No, it hasn't been cut. Perhaps a little bit trimmed at the sides.
Yes.
It's black chalk, and then over the chalk has been brown wash.
Mm.
Probably yes. There's some white heightening, some traces of white heightening here. I don't know what the subject is. It's too young, a shepherdess here.
Do you think that
usual.
This has been in any of these kind of books? This particular drawing?
I doubt whether it's been published, but it could be for an engraving, or it could be a study for a picture. I mean, to do the work on that, you would have to leave it with us, and then we would photograph it.
Yeah,
and
well,
we could either ask the people that did the Nantes exhibition, or we would go to the Witt Library, which is a large photographic mm-hmm. library, and we could check through all the Natoire material and see if we could connect it. It has been hanging on somebody's wall, and drawings, when they hang, if they're subjected to a lot of light, they fade, so it's slightly faded.
Mm, but I think that's what makes it pretty. But this is the original, this greenish.
This is absolutely the original drawing. I think there's no, that's not a, I don't think I'm making a mistake.
New
I'm making
yes,
it a.
Is the absolute.
No, it's absolutely a drawing. It is not a reproduction.
Not at all.
No.
So, well, you must tell me, I'm dying to know, how much do you, at a rough ballpark figure as this, here in the States, what would you say it was worth?
I would say about, he's gone up enormously. He used to make in the late 70s nothing, you know, £50, mm-hmm. £100, and now I would think this is worth anything between £1,200 and £1,800.
Really?
So, yes. Very much.
12 and 1800 pounds.
Yes, we've sold them. We sold, I mean, once, wow. I mean, something like this that's reproduced in the book, this watercolor, highly finished, mm-hmm. this would be worth about 40 to 60 thousand, something
well,
like
oh,
that.
Yes.
Sort of,
because well,
this, it's because more,
this is
course,
this picture,
yes,
and this
yes.
is just a tiny bit of the drawing. Mm. Well, that's wonderful because I have to admit I didn't pay nearly as much as that.
Well done, you. Good.
Yes, but I have to give it to the BBC. Rather than try. You'd think they'd give it to me, wouldn't you?